Jean, and welcome to my channel. Today we are talking about energy management, and I'm gonna get really preachy because we're coming up to the new year, and so I always get into the whole gung-ho coaching attitude. So I just want to talk about energy management today and how important it is. You literally have to treat your energy and time like it is money. Don't just give it away and only invest in things that you are getting a return on. And the reason why I say you have to protect your energy is because you only have so much to give before your energy is depleted. You guys, and when I say to invest in things that only give you a return, things do not have to be tangible. Things could be something as simple as personal fulfillment. So what you really want to do moving forward is really pay attention to how you feel when you're sitting with your friends. Pay attention to how you feel when you leave them. Pay attention to how you feel when you leave certain conversations, and really start paying attention to the people, place, and things that you're giving your energy to, because we are in a world full of energy suckers and people will take. So you really have to stand guard, treat your energy and time like money, and disperse it in a wise way. And there's many ways you can go about doing this. When I say to pay attention to how you feel when you're sitting with people, if you find yourself feeling depleted, it doesn't mean that you necessarily have to stop hanging out with that person. It just means that you can take the small little tweaks and changes and take control over the conversation that you guys are having when you're together. Oftentimes, it is as simple as that. What you are talking about is either gonna be inspiring or it's gonna be, I wouldn't say depressing, but I say low vibrating. Like a lot of times when you're gossiping and you're talking about other people, whether you know it or not, it's a very low vibration. And what is that doing for either one of your personal fulfillments? Nothing. Because this is something that you have to realize, you guys, and I've become so aware of this lately. As women, oftentimes we always sit around and we gossip, right? And what are we gossiping about? We're gossiping about shit that happened, things that we don't like in our life. It's just, that's just what, I mean, men probably do it too, but not as much as women do. That's just what people do. But you guys have to realize, every time you tell the story, you're projecting and keeping yourself in that story, meaning that the story is not going to change. And we have so much control over what we attract in and what we project out into our reality, that if you start changing the story that you're telling, your life will change. So that's just why I say to really pay attention to how you're feeling. And if you want to get unstuck from the stories that you tell and unstuck from the life that you're living, it's as simple as making these tiny changes, because tiny changes eventually make big changes.